Introducing the Houston family, ready for action. Playing against the Casey family, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. And now, here's your host, a perfect 10, John O'Hurley.
Hello there and welcome to Family Feud. Oh, ho, 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 boy, this family will not be beat. Returning for the third time, $20,840 to their credit. It's the Houston family. Hello, Tamika. We know each other well enough to hug now. It seems like you guys have been here for a while. Okay.
Yes.
Introduce me again to the rest of the family.
Okay, real quickly, this is my expecting sister, Erica.
Hello,
Erica. My other expecting sister, Arca. My adorable niece, Adra, and that's Big Eric on the end.
Big Eric is always on the end. Okay. All right, we have the Casey family over here. Hello, Kelly. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
You have that pretty Irish face.
Thank you.
And an Irish name to go with it. Introduce me to the rest of the family.
Thank you. This is my wonderful family. This is Dawn. This is my cousin. This is my handsome husband, Kevin.
Hello, Kevin.
This is my cousin, Lori. And last but not least... this is my cousin and her husband, Ernie.
Hello, Ernie. Okay. Good luck to you both. Are you ready to play the feud?
Yeah.
All right, Tamika, Kelly, come on up here. All righty. Now, Tamika's an Irish name, too. All right. We surveyed 100 people. Top five answers are on the board. Try to get the most popular answer. Name something you might need if you went hunting with Vice President Dick Cheney. Right here. Tamika?
A bulletproof vest.
Bulletproof vest. Poor Dick Cheney. Show me bulletproof vest. Another one answer. Okay. Pass the play?
We're going to play.
You're going to play. Okay. Kelly, go on back. All right, here. Let's just put your little ice cream cone back on top there. Keeps the sound people happy, and I know somebody's ear just popped when I did that. But name something that you might need if you went hunting with Vice President Dick Cheney.
A shotgun.
Shotgun.
That's right. Great answer.
You got to fire back. If you're fired upon, show me shotgun. All right. Those writers are merciless. Arca, how about you?
You need the bright colored clothing when you go hunting.
Bright colored clothing. Show me lots of orange. No. Okay. All right, Audra, what would you need if you went hunting with Vice President Dick Cheney?
I would say bullets.
Bullets. Bullets. No reason to be shooting blanks. Show me bullets. No. I don't know what they're thinking of. Eric, how about you?
You know what?
Dick Cheney, what do you need?
I think I would need a whole bunch of bodyguards.
Oh, bodyguards! Yeah. Show me bodyguards! Bodyguards is there. All right. All right, Tamika, coming back down to you. Now, you heard two buzzes. That means you got two strikes. One more strike, it goes over there to the Casey family that's already circling. Give me an answer.
I'm going to say...
3 seconds.
A first aid kit.
First aid kit. Certainly makes sense. To continue in the game, first aid kit. No. All righty. Coming over here right now to the Casey family. All right, Ernie?
Camouflage.
All right. We're going to say camouflage.
All right. Your first answer, if it's going to be right, if that answer's on there, you steal the points. If not, it goes right back to the Houstons. Show me camouflage. No, but good thinking, all right. Something that you might need if you went hunting with Vice President Dick Cheney. Show me number three. Is he swinging at you or something up there? Show me the final answer. Sure. Oh, boy. Let's get to our second question right now. Erica, Don, join me at the center. All right, nice to see you, Don. Okay, Erica, as always. Top six answers are on the board. Get the most popular answer, please. Name something every good couch potato needs. We go right here to Erica.
Remote control.
Yeah. Remote control. Certainly makes sense. Show me remote control. Number one answer. Okay, pass the play. You're going to play. All right, take your spot back there. Hello, Arthur. Coming yes. down to you. Look me straight in the eye as always and tell me something that every good couch potato needs.
Food, of course.
Yeah. Food. Yeah.
That's right. You got to feed the beast. Show me food. Food is right. Audra, when you're parked on the couch, what would you need?
A TV guide.
All TV right, guide. Right. That's right. You can't tell the players without a program. Show me TV guide. Oh. Only a couch potato knows what's on. All right, one strike.
Well, I'm not a couch potato.
That's
I'm,
all right, you know, but you know something.
I get out. But if I were, I would use a comfortable chair.
Yes, sir.
Comfortable
answer.
Chair.
Great answer.
Tell me a comfortable chair.
Yeah!
Comfortable chair. All right. All right, Tamika.
Okay.
Only have one strike. You get a little bit of leeway right here. Okay. Sure. Tell me something that every good couch potato needs.
Well, when I'm watching The Feud, I need some peace and quiet.
Yeah!
Peace and quiet. Tell me peace and quiet. I understand that because it's a very, we run a very contemplative game right here.
Yeah,
peace and
right.
quiet would help. Erica, how about you? You got two strikes against you. You need this or it goes back over to the Casey family to steal. Something every good couch potato needs.
A pillow.
Pillow.
Yeah, pillow.
Doesn't make sense to me. Show me pillow to stay in the game. Pillows are there. All right, Erica.
I'm thinking.
Two strikes. You get this, you're still alive. If not, we go for the steal.
A good program to watch. A good show.
A program.
A good show.
Absolutely. Content is everything. A good program to watch. No. All righty. All right. 89 points up on the board, Ernie.
Phone.
All right. Apparently, it's consensus down there. Kelly, what think you?
An easy access cordless phone.
Phone. If phone is there, 89 points dropped in your lap. If not, it goes back to the Houston family. Show me the phone. No. Oh, it made such sense, too. Of course you need a telephone. They didn't think so. Let's reveal the remaining answers. The number five thing you need if you're a couch potato. A friend. All right. And the final thing every couch potato needs. All right. Have a little chat with these judges, huh? Okay. Houston family still in the lead, 175 points. Casey family has yet to score. But remember, we're looking for 300 points, so don't go away because we're coming back. Okay, we've got some competition here. Welcome back to Family Feud. The Houston family remains in the lead at 175 points. Casey family yet to score, but time for another face-off. Arca, Kevin, join me backstage here. All right, give me that look in the eye. There we go. All right, we're ready to work now. We're going to double the value of the points right now. So the scores are going to really move here. Top six answers on the board. Please get the most popular answer. Name a song Michael Jackson sang in the days when he still had a nose. Arca goes to you.
ABC.
Show me ABC. ABC. All right. Good, but not the number one answer. So dip back into that musical memory of yours,
that's
Kevin.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Beat It.
Beat It.
Good answer. Good answer.
Even Arca says good answer. Beat It.
Yeah.
All right, that's enough to cut. Cut to control the question. Pass or play?
Play.
All right, you're going to play. Arca, go on back. All right, here, where are you? All right, Kevin, you were up there. Laurie, first one. And that was my closest thing I've ever done to a moon dance. May that never happen again. All right. Laurie, name a song Michael Jackson sang in the days when he still had a nose.
Thriller.
Thriller.
Yes.
Tell me Thriller. Number one answer. All right, Ernie. Don't take that deep breath on me. You had all of his. You had all of his albums back when they were still albums.
Oh yeah, I did. Right. We'll have to go with Billie Jean.
Billie Jean. Nice. Is Billie Jean your lover? Yes, it is. All right, Kelly. Michael Jackson song, back in the days when the nose was still there. Back when a nose was a nose.
Oh.
3 seconds.
I love you, darling.
Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
Tell me, love you, darling. Oh, right off the top of your head, I know that. All right, Don.
I'm going to go with Dirty Diana.
Dirty Diana. Is Dirty Diana up there? No. All right, that's 2 strikes, Kevin. You got us into all of this. You better get us out. You got to keep this family alive. You got 2 strikes. One more strike, and it goes over there to the Houston family. You don't want to give it to them, do you?
Ooh, no, not
okay.
At all. Love me.
Love me.
All right. All right.
Love me. Show me love me to stay alive. No, it isn't there. All righty. You must win. What do you got? Bad is all I'm hearing. Tamika, let me hear something.
I'm bad.
Yeah!
Yeah, bad!
Tamika is bad! Show me for the win. It is. All right, now there's only one remaining answer, which has got to be the national anthem, I would think. Anyway, show me the number 5 song. Old favorite for Michael Jackson would be... I'll Be There. Well, unfortunately, you're going to miss this family. Thank you very much, Kelly, Don, Kevin, Lauren. Thank you again. Thank you for being with us today. All right, Houston Family One, I need some fast money players right here. Around, my dear. All right, Eric. Yes, they won. They're coming back to play for $20,000 on Fast Money.
Which Family Feud host played Al Borland on Home Improvement? Richard Karn, an actor playing a host, but now really a host. More Family Feud is coming right up.
All right, well, the Houston family won yet again. It's time to play Fast Money now for $20,000. Erica, you're no stranger to this. We have taken Eric off stage. We gave him a coloring book, some crayons. He's pretty well occupied. The point is he can't see or hear your answers. I'm going to ask you 5 questions. You have 20 seconds to answer. You give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, just say pass, and we'll come back to it if we have some time, all right? Now, if you and Eric together come up with 2,200 points, you know what you get.
$20,000!
$20,000! It turns her speechless. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to need 20 seconds on the clock, please. The clock is going to start after I read the first question. Here we go. Tell me what time you'd have to wake up to watch the sunrise.
6 a.m.
What's the first sport you ever learned to play?
Basketball.
Name something that moves very slowly.
A turtle.
Name something men hate to be teased about.
Their hair.
Name something you'd buy by the case.
Beer.
Okay, all good answers. That thinking girl. All right, Miss Sweet.
Good answer. Good answer, Erica.
All right, my darling. I need 200 points. Let's start off good here. We asked you to tell us something, or tell us the time that you'd have to wake up to watch the sunrise. You said... Survey says... Yes. Very good beginning. What's the first sport that you ever learned to play? You said... Basketball, survey says. All right. Name Find something that moves very slowly, you said. Turtle. Survey says. Whoa! Honey, child, you are moving in the right direction. Saying something men hate to be teased about, you said. The hair, survey said. We keep this going, we may keep Eric out there with his coloring book. Name something you buy by the case. You said beer, survey said. Very good. All right, clear the board. Let's bring out Eric. All right, I'll tell you, Eric, all you need, believe it or not, is just 14 points. Yeah. All right. Just 14 points. We're going to be right back to find out if Eric can finish the job that Erica started. So stay with us. Boy, I'll tell you, welcome back. What a job Erica did for you. 186 points. You only need 14 points to win. 14 points, and that's another $20,000 for the Houston family. Wow. Something off the top of your head. What are you going to do with $20,000?
Well, I just got married 2 months ago. My wife and I are going to take a big bite out of the Big Apple.
Awful. All right. Well, let's hope we're sending you to New York in style. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You can't duplicate any of the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this sound. It scares me every time. And then I'm going to say, try it again. You're going to give me another answer. Now, it's going to be a little tougher, so you get 25 seconds instead of 20. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's remind everyone of Erica's answers. Okay. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Time will start after I read the first question. Good luck to you, Eric. Here we go. Tell me what time you'd have to wake up to watch the sunrise.
6 a.m.
Another, please.
5:30.
What's the first sport you ever learned to play?
Kickball.
Name something that moves very slowly.
Snail.
Name something a man hates to be teased about.
His hair.
Another, please.
His weight.
Name something you'd have to buy by the case.
Beer.
Another, please.
Milk.
All right, good answers. Let's see.
All right, Eric.
I don't know what you guys
all you need is 14 points. We may never get to the case of milk.
Good job.
Are you ready, Eric?
I'm ready.
For $20,000.
I'm so ready.
Tell me what time you'd have to wake up to watch the sunrise. You said, and you only need 14. 5:30 a.m. Survey says. There, got it right there. Number one answer was 6 a.m. First sport you ever learned to play, baseball or softball. Something that moves very slowly, a turtle or a tortoise. Name something that men hate to be teased about. Well, of course, it's their hair or losing it. And you name something you buy in a case, well, they already got it. It's beer. Congratulations to the Houston family. 3-day total, $40,840. And they're coming back on our next show for another chance to win $20,000. And we're going to see you, yes, next time, right here on The Feud. Bye for now.